गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम जशनदीप सिंह, योर बायोलॉजी टीचर ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ पैरामाउंट पब्लिक स्कूल। टुडे वी आर स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ आवर बॉडी फ्लूइड एंड सर्कुलेशन, दैट इज ब्लड वेसल्स। ओके, देयर आर थ्री काइंड ऑफ ब्लड वेसल्स। फर्स्ट इज कैपिलरीज, आर्टरीज एंड वेन्स। ओके बेटा, दीज थ्री ब्लड वेसल्स हेल्प्स टू ट्रांसपोर्ट और सर्कुलेट द ब्लड थ्रू द बॉडी। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट ब्लड वेसल, दैट इज नोन एज द कैपिलरीज। कैपिलरीज आर स्मॉलेस्ट ब्लड वेसल। दीज कैपिलरीज आर डिस्कवर्ड बाय, ओके, और इट मीन अ दैट साइंटिस्ट विच गिव द नेम ऑफ दीज ब्लड वेसल, दैट इज नोन एज द मार्सेलो मालपीसिए। दीज आर द स्मॉलेस्ट ब्लड वेसल। Okay, it means these are the narrowest kind of blood vessels, and these narrowest kind of blood vessels have a 8 micron meter diameter. These help, they are also known as the exchange vessels. Exchange vessels mean these are helps to exchange the material between the blood and body tissues. The arteries and veins are large blood vessels, so these blood vessels are not directly contact with the any organ or body tissues. So these capillaries help in the transportation of these whole kind of blood from body tissue or to the cells, or body tissue to a blood or a blood vessels. Okay, and these are of a two types, arteriolar capillaries and venular capillaries. Okay, as per the name, these are the capillaries which connect with the arteries, and these arteries or capillaries helps to transport the respiratory gases. Okay, and these are the venular capillaries. Venular mean those kind of capillaries which are joined or connected with the veins, and their type of capillaries helps to collect the metabolic waste which are secreted by or formed by a body tissues. Okay, that's all about these capillaries. These capillaries are the network like structure formed in the lungs, heart, every kind of organs and tissues. Okay, thus next blood capillaries known as the arteries, and these are the widest, okay, or the largest blood capillaries. Okay, the diameter of arteries are 120 micrometer outer, jodi main these main arteries have a diameter of 120 micrometer. Okay, and the arterioles, which are the branches of these arteries, have a less diameter than a arteries, that is a 70 micrometer. These contain a sphincter. Okay, these are the very simple terms. These arteries transport the oxygenated blood except a pulmonary artery. Okay, and these contain a sphincter. Okay, these sphincters helps to maintain the flow of blood through these arteries. These are thick walled and narrow lumen. Okay, and these have a smooth muscles which helps to maintain the contraction and relaxation. Okay, the contraction of these arteries or blood vessels is known as a vasoconstriction, and the relaxation of these blood vessels is known as a vasodilation. Okay, so these arteries helps to transport oxygenated blood from heart to body parts, and the third form of blood vessel are known as the veins. Veins or veins. Okay, these are the thin walled and broad lumen. They have a very thin cell wall, cell membrane. Okay, and these are the structures of these arteries and veins. Okay, beta, and these artery contain a thick body wall. Thick walled, it means these contain a three layers. These both contain a three layers. Tunica externa. External layer of these two blood vessels, median layer, tunica media. Middle layer is known as a tunica media, and the internal layer of these two blood vessels is known as a tunica interna. Okay, and this empty space between them is known as a lumen. Okay, as per you see, look at these two blood vessels, the lumen of artery is very very less, so the blood pressure inside the artery is very more. Okay, very high. Approximately this artery contain a very normal blood pressure, that is 80 to 180 mm of Hg, and the between these veins the blood pressure is 0 mm of Hg. Okay, the lumen of these veins is very very broad. Okay beta, and arteries lacks the walls, and these veins contain walls which prevent the backflow of blood. Okay, and it's all about these blood vessels. Okay, thank you very much.